Hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you the easiest way to sort an array in C++. So instead of writing like the bubble sort code, quick sort code, you have like so many sorting algorithms. Instead of writing bunch of codes, you can just use this simple function to sort your array in just three lines of code. So let's get started. So first let me declare an array, okay, int arr. Let me have some random values in it, 6, 3, 9, 10 and 1. I have 2 also, okay. So the first thing what we need to do is we need to get the length of our array. So in C++ we don't have any inbuilt function to get the length of the array. So we need to find it manually. So let l equal to, it's really simple, okay, size of arr slash size of arr of 0. So what it means that in our array, okay, each element has 4 bytes, okay. So this one is 4, 4, 4, 4 and 4. So our size of arr will give us 6 into 4, because we have 6 elements and each one occupies 4 bytes, so it's going to be 6 into 4, 24. So this one is going to be 24 and this one is going to be size of only the first element, okay. It can be any element, we can take AR of 1, 2, random element. So for like, because the size is going to remain the same, 4 bytes, okay. So what happens is that we are going to divide the entire size by a single size. As the sizes are same, we will get the total number of elements present in the array. This is the simplest way to find the length of an array in C++. So here it's going to be 24 by 4, we will be getting L as 6. So as I told you earlier, for sorting the array, it's going to be sort. And here you are going to pass ARR, only ARR, this is like an address, okay, just ARR. And this is a starting value, and ARR plus L, this is the ending value, okay. And for the sort function to work, you need to import this header file as include bit slash stdc++.h, otherwise you will be getting an error. So now I'll just print it, okay. Print our array for int I equal to 0, I less than, and you see L, I plus plus, and I'll just put C out error of I and just print it. So if I just run it down, so as you can see here, my array has been completely sorted. And what happens is that this is a starting portion, okay. This basically corresponds to the 0th index of our array, and this corresponds to the 0 plus L, okay, till the ending minus 1. So you have like the for loop over here. We have like, it's going to start from 0, and I less than L means it will stop from 0 to L minus 1. Same thing, it starts from ARR 0 and the last index minus 1. So we are passing L is going to be 6, okay. If you want, means I will just print out, see out L, okay, see out value of L, and I will just put L, okay, just put end L also, just run it. So as you can see here, I am getting C out value of L as 6. So what happens is that it's just going to be ARR till ARR of 5th index, okay, because it starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So suppose if I want only a particular, like let's say I want only the first 4 elements to be sorted. So in that case, I need to put in ARR, comma ARR of, instead of L, I will just put 4. So this basically corresponds to ARR of 0 till ARR of 3. So we will be getting 6, 3, 9 and 10. Our 1 and 2 won't be getting sorted. So we will be getting the output as 3, 6, 9, 10 and then 1 and 2. Okay. So as you can see here, our first 4 elements are getting sorted and last 2 elements are getting neglected because of our value. So you can just play around with this. It's really cool. It's the easiest way, but not the fastest way, because sort function also performs some n log n operations. Because the inbuilt function, it performs this operations as background. The quickest sorting algorithm is n log n, like merge sort, and we have other sorting algorithms as well. So it's n log n in time complexity. So it's not the quickest, but it's the easiest way. You can reduce your code length instead of just thinking and typing it around. You can just use sort function and just quickly finish your code. So that's it for this video. And I also introduced in C, C++, Python, Java, Blender, that is 3D animation, Unity. So it will be really great if you could check other videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.